Project Gaines, episode 11, Tag Team Trials. The four duelists make their way to an open field that was just conveniently around in the area.
In case you don't know how tag duels work, I'll give you the lowdown.
Oh boy, this will be all kinds of wrong.
Each team has 8,000 life points to share.
Yep.
You cannot use each other's monsters to attack, but you can use each other's monsters to tribute, synchro, and Z summon.
Yeah.
You can also make use of each other's spells and traps, but the controller of that trap has to be able to activate it first. However, you can use your traps on your partner's turn. Each player also has use of their side's graveyard.
Anime rulings, lovely.
That's about it in terms of the rules. You got that? Sounds good. Now let's do this. I'll kick off this duel.
Surprise gets that box.
Alright, first of all, I'm gonna set a monster face down. But not only that, but I'm gonna set two other cards face down. And I believe that's gonna be a turn for me.
As soon as I can set it to damn.
I draw. First of all, I'm gonna normal summon Noble Knight Boris to the field and attack.
Oh boy, Noble Knights. What do I call that thing again? Oh yeah, the letdown
this
archetype.
This monster counts as a normal monster while there's no equipped spells equipped to it. I'll take advantage of that by special summoning Noble Knight Garland to the field in defense mode through his special ability.
Tom immediately takes offense to this because he claims he
now
stole
then,
his card.
I'm bars with Noble Knight Galantine. Now gains 1,000 attack points and its special ability. So now it activates. I'll select three Noble Knight Arms cards in my deck, and you have to choose one of them randomly to add to my hand, Rez.
Why him?
Because I said so.
Said so. Now choose.
I was kidding.
Left, right, or middle.
Would have helped if I could see them.
Yeah.
Whatever.
It's called random.
Let's go with the one on the left.
It's not very random. Double you know what they are.
Caliburn gets added to my hand.
Caliburn. That's the healing one.
Now then, I'm going to activate Noble Knight Caliburn and equip it to my Noble Knight board.
Like freaking grabby X.
So now I activate the fact so that our side gains 500 life points.
We're ahead by 500 life points now.
Woo! I can heal Tama you and make you even again. Press can final flame you and make you lose it.
I send one card face down. It's your turn, Press boy.
It's my turn now.
Please activate final flame. Don't make me a liar, Press.
For me to start things off,
but anyway, I wouldn't be a liar. He could do it.
I can special summon the Fiend Mega Cyber from my hand.
Surprised you run that.
Well, looks like Prez and I share a few common monsters.
Next up, you're in the same dimension.
Blake Spreader Zombie in attack mode. Blake Spreader Zombie also happens to be a tuner monster. So I'll tune
level 6
Fiend Mega Cyber with my level 2 Plague Spreader Zombie to synchro summon Blood Mephist!
Going for that one already, okay. Fred's probably ain't gonna kill a damn thing.
I know about that card. One of a kind, not to mention powerful.
Well then, I'll just activate the trap, Fiendish Chain.
Ah, fudge.
So now your monster loses its abilities. And it can't attack.
No! Damn it. Well, luckily for me, I always have a plan B.
Do you
I'll activate the spell card Monster Reborn.
What? Why?
This spell card will allow me to bring back the Fiend Mega Cyber from my grave.
Because you really need that attacking? Oh, wait. Plague Spreader's effect.
And next, by placing one card in my hand back onto the top.
Could go for another synchro immediately.
Spreader Zombie back to the field. Only catch is, next time it goes to the graveyard, it's banished instead. But that's okay, because now with these two monsters, I can synchro summon again!
Black and
not
Dark End Dragon.
What'd you expect from a Legend of Duel Monsters?
Yeah.
Something easier?
You two
You're an idiot.
Now I'll tune Plague Spreader Zombie with the Fiend Mega Cyber one more time to synchro summon Thought Ruler Archfiend!
I was kind of expecting Dark End Dragon so then he could have popped Fiendish Chain.
Well, it appears on even your very first turn you can summon a lot of your strongest monsters.
That's what I do best after all.
Yeah.
I'll place one card face down to end my
I think this is the third episode in a row where Prez has done this. Two level six, a level six and a level two to make a level eight. What?
So now, since you control monsters while I don't, I can special summon a Gaga monster to the field.
Oh,
I special summon the Gaga magician.
You know, my brother's deck had some Gaga cards.
Randy.
Well, I highly doubt you can use them as good as me. Anyway,
as good as I.
I now normal summon Gaga girl.
The wannabe waifu.
Then I activate Gaga Magician's special ability, making the level 7. Then I activate Gaga Girl's special ability,
making her
the
level
same
7.
Level as Gaga Magician.
Two level 7s. Beware, Prez. He's ready to summon something big.
Well, whatever it is they have, and since they finally drew some balls, bring it on!
With pleasure. Now I overlay my two monsters with Z-Summon, Dark Magician of Illusion.
Oh boy. Hello.
I don't think I've heard of that card before.
Well,
new
I
card.
Especially considering this card is not going to be available to the public until tomorrow. Let's just say us card hunters have connections.
So wait, you Connors have access to the newest cards before they even come out to
pretty much.
I was talking!
Shut up.
It's easy to give yourself an unfair advantage instead of playing fair. Gutless. Each and every one of you.
Says the one who stole cards.
Just have to operate and achieve our goals. If you got a problem with that, just talk to a higher up.
Yeah, right. Like they're gonna chat with these two over some tea.
Shut up. I didn't come here to play tea and dress up. If anything, it'll be your heads on a platter soon enough.
Oh, snap. This dude's serious. Why wouldn't he be? I mean, you guys steal decks, sometimes even killing the original owners in the process. And
we haven't done that yet.
Enough! I'd like to continue my turn if you don't mind.
Oh, and I forgot.
Well, they did take the brother's soul, so I guess that's the same thing.
Because I'm activating the counter trap card, Black Horn of Heaven.
You wait a while to do that.
Now with this card, it can negate the special summon of your magician and destroy it.
Well, I guess I'll just set two cards and end my turn.
Alright, now begins my turn and the onslaught. First of all, I'll activate the trap for my Geki Break. So now, I can discard a card from my hands and destroy your boards. When my noble lawns are sent to the graveyard, I can just re-equip them to my next noble knight. So now my noble lawns card equipped to my noble knight Gawain.
But Gawain's in defense, so he doesn't get any of
the
power
boosts.
The card
is kind of useless since your noble knight Gawain is in defense
mode. Well,
it gets
the power boost. It just doesn't matter, you know?
When you put it that way. Now then, I'll normal summon my ninja Grandmaster Sasuke to the field in attack mode.
Not a poppet, just in case.
Now I activate compulsory escape device.
It's evacuation.
Now place your monster back in your hat.
Dang it. Well, I guess I'll end it there.
You had me worried there, partner, but you always pull through. Thanks.
Don't mention it. Seriously, don't.
Ever.
Well,
I'll have
then,
your head.
I'll just normal summon my effect banner to the field.
Why? Okay.
Then I tune my monsters together to synchro summon Ignoble Knight of Highlander Street.
Oh boy, a synchro.
A synchro of your own, huh?
Yeah. And since I used Noble Knight Gawain for a synchro summon, all the noble arms cards I equipped it with get to put it to my Ignoble Knight of Highlander Street. So now, my Synchro has 3,600 attack points.
Don't!
And now I activate my Synchro's effect. When I was Synchro summoned, I can choose a noble arms directly from my deck and equip it to him. I choose my noble arms of destiny. My monster can't be destroyed by those pesky card effects or by battle.
I guess direct attacks are out of the question for this guy. But that's alright. I'll just go for your partner then.
Whatever. I attack Thought Rule Archfiend! So fast, card hunters, I activate my impenetrable attack trap card. Now, Prez's monster is safe. Unfortunately, we still take the damage.
Thanks, man. But don't think I'll be forgetting that.
Don't mention it. Yeah, whatever. During my main phase 2, I activate the effect of Caliburn again, so we gain yet another 500 life points.
Woo.
The difference between our life points grow. Why don't you just give us your dex to avoid any more pain?
I can summon an Alexandrite dragon and attack you directly, and then boom, I'm weirwitting.
We have nothing to gain from surrendering to creeps like yourselves.
Who are you calling a creep?
Well, let's see. He's not talking to me, and you two are the only conscious people around here. So, quite frankly, he's calling you two creeps.
Shut up!
Hey, buddy! Are you gonna end your turn or what?
Yeah, quit rushing me. I'm ending my turn.
Well, don't go crying after I make your life points hit zero, kid.
He's not fair.
Graceful charity. This card lets me draw 3 cards, and then I have to discard 2 to the graveyard. Next, I'll play Painful Choice. With this spell card, I can choose 5 monsters in my deck, and then you choose 1 of the 5. The rest go to the graveyard, but whatever card you choose will get added back to my hand. So I'll choose Rainbow Dark Dragon, Dark Horus, Dark Lord Zerato, Dark Nephthys, and a deal with Dark Ruler. Take your pick.
And we're gonna make
all
you
of them are
choose.
High-level monsters.
Me?
Yes, you. What? You've got your
return the favor.
Box from this morning stuck up your head. Let's go. Choose.
Says the one with purple
choose
hair.
Partner. If you choose wrong, it could end up going bad for us.
Yeah, I don't want all this pressure.
Just choose for Pete's sake. I mean, it's not like your lives depend on it.
Oh, wait, it does.
And you know we'll be brought back.
Deal, Dark Ruler.
It doesn't take a duelist like Yugi Miyamoto to know that you screwed up big time.
Wait, I changed my mind.
Never mind. No takesies-backsies.
You freaking twit. You guys are great. Now watch the magic happen. First off, I'll sacrifice my blood Mephist to summon the symbol of force, the Great Machu Garset.
5,600 attack.
When this card is summoned, its attack points become double the monster that was used to tribute for it. That gives it 5,600 points.
That's just 200 points shy of a Cyber Twin Dragon on Power Bond.
You imbecile, why'd you choose a spell call?
Yeah, because all those monsters are sent to the graveyard. Apparently, somebody here hasn't ever seen Prez duel. Or else he would know that Prez's strategy relies on filling up his graveyard. Why didn't you tell me that, partner?
Oh, I don't know. Him being a dueling legend, I thought that would have been common knowledge.
Well then, if you know me so well, you should know what happens next.
I win!
I'll activate the spell card that you gave me. A deal with Dark Ruler. Since my level 8 Blood Mephist was sent to the graveyard this turn, I can summon from my deck the creature of your demise, Berserk Dragon!
Man, jeez. Say goodbye to everything you know. Say goodbye to everything. Bye.